Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Umar, and today we'll be creating a tutorial on how to create ribs in SolidWorks. And we'll be doing this by doing three examples. Basically, ribs are created to give strength to your part, and they act as reinforcement in your structure. So let's go to here SolidWorks. So let's go to here New and click Part and click OK. And now we are in SolidWorks interface. First of all, I'll change my background to plain white, and I'll go to here front plane, click sketch, and let's say I'll go to here line tool, and we'll make a line here, one line here, one line here, and I'll join this line to this point. Okay, let's dimension it. First select this line, hold shift key, select this line and make equal, and go to smart dimension and let's dimension it 20. Okay, and let's say this line is 80 millimeters, and let's say this line is also 80. Now you can see that sketch is fully defined, and let's go to here features, go to your extruded boss, and select this mid plane, and let's say change this to 120 millimeters. Okay, click OK. Now we can make a rib. So let's go to here rib, and select plane, let's say a front plane, and the rib will be created in the center of this geometry. So let's click here front plane and normal to view, and click here line, and we can create rib, let's say, by selecting this point and this point, but I'll be creating a rib, let's say, from this point to this point, and just rotating our geometry. Now you can see that a preview is generated, and you can see the thickness of the rib, and you can change it from here, let's say 20 millimeters. Now you can see the thickness. This rib is on both sides, and this rib on the left side and this rib on the right side. And we can also change this, but normal to sketch is not work here because you have a geometry here, and let's change it to here thickness and click OK. Now you can see your rib. We can apply draft feature as well. Go to here rib again, edit feature, and let's say I'll click here draft, and I'll change this to, let's say, 15 degree, and click OK. Now you can see a draft, inward draft and outward draft both will work. Let's make another rib, and let's go to here rib feature, and this time I will select this face, and normal to view, and click here line, and this time I will choose, let's say, this point to this point. Okay, just rotating our geometry. Well, this rib will not work here because there is no geometry, and if I choose this one, second side, now this rib will work because there is geometry, right? And neither this rib will not work. Okay, so let's choose this one, second side, and click OK. Now you can see your rib. Okay, let's try another example, and let's go to here new and click part, and okay, let's select, let's say, this time top plane, and let's go to here center rectangle, let's create a center rectangle, and let's dimension it, let's say maybe 180 180 by 120, and click OK. Go to here features, extruded boss, and I will extrude it to, let's say, 40 mm. Click OK, and let's change this to plain white. Okay, let's go to here shell feature, and select this face, and let's change it to 5 mm. Next is, we'll create some ribs on this box, and it is very important to select your plane while creating ribs. Don't select this face, but you have to select this face because your ribs will be extruded in negative Z direction. Okay, so let's go to here rib, and I will select this face, view normal, and we'll create some lines here. Let's say one center line here, and one line, let's say, here, and maybe one line here. I will not dimension these. And let's apply some in this horizontal direction as well, one line, let's say here, and one last line maybe here. Okay, sketch is completed. It is underdefined, but it's okay. And let's go to here, and now you'll see your ribs preview. Just rotate it, and let's change this thickness to maybe 5 mm, and we can apply a draft as well, but I think it's okay. You can change these two, let's say first side or left side, both sides, or right side. Okay, let's change it to both sides and click OK. Now you will see your ribs preview. We can apply a draft as well, inward draft or outward draft. Well, these are very important when we are dealing with injection molding. And lastly, I'll be creating another example. So let's go to here, new, and click part and click OK. And let's say maybe select this front plane, and I'll be creating a circular boss. So click here, line tool, and one line, let's say here. Let's go to here, 3-point arc, and select this point, and maybe here. Okay, let's go to your features, revolve boss, select this line as the axis of revolution, and now you'll see your preview, and click OK. Now go to your shell, select this face and change it to 2mm shell, click OK. And now I can also apply a draft feature in this, sorry, I can also apply a rib feature in this, let's say a bowl, okay, a circular bowl. So let's go to your rib, and now you have to select this face, okay, because your ribs will be extruded in this negative Z direction. So click this face and view normal, and let's go to the line tool. Let's apply one line, let's say here, and one line maybe here. Okay, I think these lines are enough. We can apply one line, let's say maybe here, and one line here. Let's select this line, hold shift key and make it coincident. Okay, click here. Now you'll see your ribs preview, and let's change this to maybe 2 mm, and just rotate it and click OK. Now you'll see your ribs preview. Okay, we can also section this. These are very easy to create while using this rib feature, and if you are doing this manually, so it is a hectic task. So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you have any questions regarding this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative videos. Thank you.